It's not about the flashing cameras and the limelight.
It's all for the love of music.
Hi, we are
Everybody Loves Irene.
On this episode of Amp Around Asia, we fought through the crazy traffic of Jakarta, Indonesia to meet not one, but five very talented musicians. Meet Irene, Yudhi, Dimas, Aulia, and Adi. Together, they form a trip-hop band that stands out in this pop-rock-oriented city. Today, we take a look at the lives of Everybody Loves Irene.
Hi, we are Everybody Loves Irene. Welcome to Jakarta.
It's 9:30
in the morning and we're going to breakfast, our breakfast place. It's in Barito. It's about 10 minutes maybe?
Yeah, 10 minutes from here. We're going to Barito.
Usually people go there in the morning for chicken porridge after breakfast.
We're going to have a rehearsal for tonight gigs. Maybe in our friend's studios. And then we're going to see our sound engineer and music producer, Panko, in his studio. At night, we are going to gigs in Hayfox. There are gathering, family gathering in Hayfox. We are meet some bands there.
Friends. Everybody was silent. We were born in 2001.
Yes.
First time the name is not Irene. It was formed in 1998, and then in 2001, we met Irene, and then we decided to we change our name into Everybody Loves Irene, and here she is, Irene, with her beautiful voice. Then we play trip hop. We have a lot of influence like rock and roll or maybe Britpop or post rock, electronic, everything we put together, and we define our own trip hop. We listen a lot to Portishead
and Massive Attack.
Because they are the trip hop band,
the oldest.
Yeah. I mean, trip hop were known by a lot of people because of them. Now in Barito for chicken porridge.
Yeah.
The name is Bubur Ayam Bandung. The taste is very maknyos.
Well, it's street vendor food, but it's cheap and delicious.
That's Ting Ting, our road manager.
This is our favorite drink. Tea in a bottle. When we play in a gigs, we always bring teh bottle in our stage.
Teh bottle, you have to sponsor Everybody Loves Irene.
We drink teh bottle, 5 bottle in a day.
Lu.
Me.
We're going to Jalan Surabaya. It's a place for vintage items, yeah? And lots of CDs, some rare CDs, vinyl albums. So let's go there. Looking for some music box for our second album materials.
A box with rotary. When you open it, there's a music inside. We're looking for it.
But instead of searching for a music box, the band ended up snooping around an old music shop which sells rare vinyls, CDs, and cassettes.
This is very cheap. From 5,000 until yang paling mahal berapa, Pak?
Paling mahal ya sekarang ya CD
starting 100,000 rupiah or $10. Most cassette. Only in Indonesia I think who still produce cassette.
Unable to find what they were looking for, the band decided to call it quits and head straight for their jamming session.
We're going to our event house for rehearsal for tonight's show, and we're going to jam with Marcella Ford. Let's go.
coming up after the break.
We still don't know how are we going to release it, how are we going to distribute it. Hopefully somebody will bringing a lot of money. One of the song from our second album, it's a hint for the Channel V viewer. Jakarta is a very crowded place, so many traffic jams, but we love living in Jakarta. Maybe someday we'll make a song about the traffic in Jakarta. Almost all of us here using motorcycle. It's not because we don't have cars, but we choose to ride motorcycle because it's easier, it's very simple.
Very effective transport.
We are our friend house, Irwan house. We want to practice our rehearsal here. We used to be shoot our video here too. Our friend, this is Wahyu from Marcel Lafoyette. This is his band, Marcel Lafoyette. They play post rock, the greatest post rock band in Indonesia. We rent this studio for
our first single, Memento Mori. We make a video clip here, and the studio is here, and we met them here. I don't need one of the song from our second album. It's a hint for the Channel V viewer. Released in 2006, it's a full DIY album. I mean, we produce ourselves. Only the distribution we use our label, the majors. The title is very long. It's the very first thing you must learn about flying.
It's gravity.
We're trying to make it very long, so people are trying to remember it. People, oh, it's very long. I cannot remember, but you will remember. Everybody Loves Irene.
Yeah.
We're now doing our second album. We're still looking for the
Label, producer,
anywhere out there
To release our album, second album.
Because the first album is always about sadness, about uncertainty, gloomy. The world is not really nice to us. And then in our second album, we change the theme and we put some love, but it's not cheesy love. I think it's
irony.
Before heading to Hey Folks for an acoustic party, the band decided to make a quick stop at their recording studio for a brief meeting with their sound engineer.
This is the place where we record our second album.
Oh, right here, like pointing guns at me, so I have to say that. What? They were nice, very workable, have talents and everything. Maybe not, okay?
For the second album, we still don't know. How are we going to release it? How are we going to distribute it? Hopefully somebody kind will help us, bringing a lot of money. Yeah, you can hear the material is already 5 song, but still without vocal.
We decide to have another session to revise the strings. Orchestras and strings based on digital offers.
Coming up after the break.
Planet of the Cliché is a part of
Everybody Loves Siren history.